Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. My name is Lieutenant Colonel Muhammad Shaukat Hayat Khan. I am from Corps of Air Defense. I was commissioned in 1984 and was commissioned in Corps of Army Air Defense. It was a personal choice, and I was motivated because my father was also in the army. And right from my childhood, I was looking at his uniform. I was, you know, observing him. His unit was a very famous unit, जिसमें कायद आज़म मोहम्मद अली जना भी आए, और आपने एक पिक्चर देखी होगी जो एक यूनिट को वो विज़िट कर रहे हैं जिसमें सोल्जर्स हैं. दैट वाज़ द रेजिमेंट 5 लाइट एयर डिफेंस. माय फादर वाज़ एक्चुअली देयर इन दैट रेजिमेंट, एंड एज अ सी बॉय ही स्टार्टेड ऑफ फ्रॉम देयर. देन ही रिटायर्ड एज एन ऑनरेरी कैप्टन फ्रॉम 100 लाइट, which is also one of the famous unit of air defense. I will tell you my father's experience, who fought 65-71 war in air defense. He was at Ravi Bridge in 1965, and he told me that people used to bring, you know, a jug of sherbet for soldiers, because they used to bring radios and giving to soldiers. They used to bring sweets for soldiers, you know. And once their convoy is passing, they are throwing flowers, they are, you know, cheering them up, welcoming them. And even my father was telling me that the civilians, they got hold of an Indian agent, you know, who was giving some indications to the aircrafts. So civilians are very active, and they really participate. And we feel that if a nation wants to fight a war, it's a whole nation. It's not only soldiers. It is complete civilians and soldiers. Air defense जो है ये चौथी fighting arm है. First fighting arm infantry है, फिर armor है, फिर artillery है. So this is on fourth number. So we are a fighting arm, but our job is to neutralize and destroy the aircraft which is approaching in our territory. So the prime responsibility is of the air force, but later on ground we are deployed on the various sites. I had seen Kargil War very closely because I was grade 2 staff officer at a very senior headquarter after the staff course, and I had actually participated in that war. And because the latest situation would come daily basis to my office, to on my table. So I knew that, as I know, we had shot down one MiG-27, one MiG-21, one helicopter, the air defense units. And you know, as per my knowledge and as I know, there were little more also. But in papers or in officially, what we know is that 3 aircrafts. Right. But as per my knowledge, maybe it is 5. War brings a lot of destruction, and our utmost effort should be, first, we should not opt for war, because it is mostly in our situation, it is always forced war from India side. We are a peaceful nation, and we always avoid, and we know that it will bring a lot of casualties on both sides. We are not made of, you know, like steel or something. We are also human beings. They are also human beings. And the bullet doesn't discriminate between an Indian and a Pakistani, right? So our utmost effort is that we should not fight war. Once in 2001, the escalation between Pakistan and India was there. I was in Malsi and Bahawalpur area. We were asked to go to Fort Abbas area and this area. So I remember I held a darbar or a meeting with my soldier. One of my barber, whose job is to, you know, make haircut and shave and this. So I was giving a motivational talk to my unit that this is the time now, you have to prove. The time has come, because we were waiting for our whole lives that there will be a war, and today we have got the orders to go for war. I am your commanding officer. I will lead you. I'll be the first one who will be in front, on front. and I'll go with you. So I remember that incident. That barber, you know, he took out his wo shave karne wala ustra jo hai na, wo he took out two. He said, sir, I will go and fight with you. You see, that is the motivation. The real soldiers are others, but this guy is a civilian. And look at his motivation. I will narrate a story of my parent unit where I got commissioned. That's 88 Light AD Defense Regiment. I came as a lieutenant in that unit. This unit is one of the greatest unit, I must say, commonly known as Jinuki unit. Why it is Jinuki unit? Even the very senior officers, you know, they call this unit as a Jinuki unit because they do miracles. Miracles in a sense that, you know, if they are asked to make a command post, in the morning it is not there, in the afternoon it is there. This unit was deployed in Parachnar, and there was one Afghani aircraft, you know, hovering around. Maybe he was having fun time, you know. They never knew that underneath his 88 Light AD Defense. So they shot him down, and it came down, and still, you know, they give me this type of military shields with the cut piece of that aircraft, you know. So that kind of monuments and shields and gifts, you know, they are giving from that aircraft. We need to do only one thing, and that is voting. हमारे अनपढ़ लोगों के वोट को मजाक किया गया उसके साथ एक अनपढ़ बंदा एक नान के पीछे भागता फिर रहा है या तो इस वोट को अनपढ़ों के लिए ख़त्म कर दें या इस वोट को सही तरीके से डलवाएं और उनको ब्लैकमेल ना होने दें अगर वो ब्लैकमेल ना हो और सही वोट पड़े सही लीडरशिप आए मिनिमम ग्रेजुएट हों लीडरशिप ठीक है और तब जाके ये पाकिस्तान ठीक हो सकता है एजुकेशन के ऊपर हेल्थ सेक्टर के ऊपर अच्छी तरह से उसका शेयर दिया जाए आप देख लें कि पिछले तकरीबन 10-20 साल से एजुकेशन को ख़राब किया गया एजुकेशन अब इतनी ख़राब हो चुकी है कि आपको आपका एजुकेशन सिस्टम में से जो चीज़ें पढ़ाई जाने वाली होनी हैं वो सारी निकल चुकी हैं और जो फजूल चीज़ें हैं वो बहुत सारी आ गई हुई हैं तो ये कौन है करने वाला They all are those people who wants to, you know, Pakistan ko jo destroy karna chahte hain. Lekin Pakistan is not to undo. Pakistan ek aisa mulk hai ki jo jisne aage badhna hi badhna hai. Kyunki isme ab bhi kuch log aise hain maujood jo Pakistan ko dilo jaan se chahte hain. Aur Pakistan aage jayega. I am 100% convinced ki Pakistan aage jaane ke liye, Pakistan piche jaane ke liye nahi hai.